Whoa! Darth Vader again?
Man, these guys are still kicking ass backstage? Come on, dude!
Luke and Vader are fighting again!
Man, oh my god! There's no end in sight with these two. Well, welcome to Outskirts Brawl. I am Darth Nihilus, aka Mind Square, here with my co-host, Nevermind. Let them know what's up, Nevermind.
What's up, everyone? Happy Thanksgiving. We are here in Brisbane, Australia, for episode 24 of OBD Brawl. And Ragnarok is only a few weeks away.
And we loved Australia so much, we decided to stay for another week. And we have a tag team match coming up later tonight. The world's finest Batman versus... Oh, I'm sorry. I got a little bit excited. It's Batman and Superman versus Ryu and Ken. Team Ansatsu Ken.
And we have a women's tag team title match. The champions versus the former champions. I wonder who's going to win this one.
There's no telling. We are still in the OBD Olympic Games, ladies and gentlemen. That means any and everything can happen. It's been an impressive season so far. I love it all.
But what is going to happen to...
Whoa. What a way to start off the episode.
The Prince of All Saiyans, who bailed out on a tag team title match last week and attacked Goku.
Yes, he laid him out.
I never thought I would see something like that ever.
I don't know, man. If I'm thinking like Vegeta, you know, like Goku has been disrespecting him in a way. It's almost like he doesn't even notice his friend. He did challenge him. He wanted a rematch after what they went through in Odyssey. So I can kind of understand. It's like he'll take any and every opponent besides Vegeta. So I would be pissed if I was Vegeta. But I'm not.
But isn't the fight against the Empire more important?
Rightly so. It should be more important. But you know how these Saiyans are, Never. They tend to let their pride get in the way.
Well, let's hear what Vegeta has to say. I wonder if he had a happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, I don't know. After what he did right before Thanksgiving, there's no telling what the Bulma and Vegeta family tree was like. It looks like he's got a lot on his mind.
Yes, he has something to get off his chest.
Yeah.
Wasting no time.
Here we go. To you and yours, I hope you have a happy Thanksgiving out there, ladies and gentlemen. I know we had one. How about you, Nevermind?
It was perfect. And it was perfect because my new book is out. Lives of the Luminaries goes on sale. It went on sale yesterday, actually. So... you can get it for half off on Amazon, and I should say 25% off on Amazon, and half off elsewhere. Click the links in the description.
Kudos to you, my brother.
Nihilus got a free copy.
Yeah, boy.
Got a point there.
Yeah, big point. lot of major points right there, Never.
Yes. He's serious.
Yeah. Somebody's about to do some serious training. I'm not talking about Goku.
It's on.
Man,
the rematch.
Man. The hyperbolic time chamber is going to be in shambles.
After 10 months, it's going to happen at Ragnarok. Two out of three falls, no DQ.
There will be, oh.
Who the hell?
Man.
Is that who I think it is?
Could be.
Is gonna have a match at Ragnarok against that guy, whoever he is. And Goku and Vegeta, it's official now.
Man, we finally get the rematch. Now this will be match 3. Well, no, it will technically be match 4 in their history if you count what happened in OBD Odyssey 1. Is that not right, Never?
It would technically be match 4, yeah, because they were both the chamber match and that gauntlet match, but this is only the second singles match.
2 out of 3 falls.
Man, Ragnarok is shaping up to be every bit as advertised.
The OBD Olympic Games, roll on.
As we look to end the year with a bang. Speaking of, we still have not heard from Jedah. We haven't seen him since the attack last week, although Palpatine definitely heard from him.
After what he said to Palpatine, it surely did not faze him after what Vader did. But to
Vader,
what we saw on the screen, it looked like a lot of damage, man.
Vader and Luke still fighting backstage. I'm getting the word now.
Man, these guys are like Shao Kahn and Thanos.
These guys are no stranger to the Empire, that's for sure. On the Death Star and in Outworld, they took them on.
And it was Ryu in the final stages of the match. Lost to Savage Opress. I gotta give it up to Ryu. He went through a lot. That final punch, man, even I would have went down from that. I couldn't take as much as he did, though. That was incredible.
This should be a really good match. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Yes, happy Thanksgiving, and I hope you have a merry future Christmas. I also have to give it up to Batman after what he went through with Black Panther during OBD Kumite 2. Man. You get some bonus points for that one, Batman.
That's sure to be on many Match of the Year lists, I'm sure, at the OBD Awards.
Here we go.
You know, it seems like ever since Batman came here, he's been on a roll, and Superman looks reinvigorated.
Look, man, the prep time is real. You cannot deny it. Look at Bruce Wayne's history. Yes, his name is Bruce Wayne. We are not breaking the fourth wall. We know who this man is, just like we know who Superman is. These are the world's finest.
Ryu now trying to take back control of the match. Batman rolls away.
Here we go. Oh, I did not expect that one.
Nice toss from Ryu.
You know, Batman really might get his skills tested in this match right here. I don't think he knows the Ansatsuken style.
And Satsuken, a high-ranked team here in the OBD. I think they're ranked third.
I mean, if you look at Batman's experience, he knows many martial arts. But Ansatsuken, I don't think that's part of his category. That remains to be seen. But I know Batman's very good. He can learn on the fly. He's kind of like Goku, even though he's a human being. He's a very smart individual.
He's much smarter than Goku is. That's for sure.
I think everybody's smarter than Goku at this point. I mean... But when it comes to a threat... Yeah! I know that hurt. Never take your eyes off the Batman. He will always surprise you.
What do you think Batman's plan is here? A couple of weeks ago, he said he had a plan with Superman.
Was he not the one that created the Justice League Watchtower? Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. We're a little tongue-tied tonight. We had a very merry Thanksgiving. I know I did, and I'm still coming off of it.
It's been all Batman in this match so far, and it just goes to show you how long he's been around, because I don't remember.
But you also have to think, Never, you know the type of dude that Batman is. He always likes to show what type of a superhero he can really be. And he's a human being. He goes the distance more than possibly any other superhero that's not superhuman.
And we saw that just now when he broke up the count. He doesn't want to win by count out.
No, he does not.
He wants to get a victory over a top tag team in the OBD. And speaking of tag teams, when the World Martial Arts tournaments come back in January, there is going to be a tag team tournament. So this is about getting ranking points and getting into that tournament in a good position.
Yes, we are watching everything, and we are taking points, just as the Living Tribunal is. He is watching this just as we are.
Points will be reset after Ragnarok, and that's when the seeding for the World Martial Arts Tournaments in all four of our divisions will be finalized to kick off the new year.
Uh-oh.
Speaking of Ragnarok, Maul and Oppress do not have challengers yet.
Like I said, never take your eyes off the Batman!
Misses there.
Oh, here we go, Never.
Nice strikes. Again!
Oh!
Here comes the cover attempt. Ryu's running into the ring. Ryu breaks up the count. He was too close.
Oh, I know that hurt. Batman's winding up again.
But Ken saw that one coming, and now Batman is in some trouble.
Yeah, Ken's wanting to even the stakes right now. You gotta think, though, Batman's got armor on, so does he really feel all of this? That's the real question right now. Ryu and Ken do not have armor.
He felt enough of it. I think if I was Batman, I'd want to tag Superman in right now. Superman has not yet been in this match.
I know he's feeling those blows to the chest, though. That's gotta hurt. This This is not a game, ladies and gentlemen. We are in the OBD Olympic Games in Ragnarok. It's on the way. Can you feel it?
The biggest event of the OBD calendar. It is only a few weeks away. December 12th and 13th is the weekend. Pre-show on the 12th, main card on the 13th.
This is not a game. Man, the second wind is real.
Batman does seem to have slowed down. I spoke too soon!
Again! One! Ooh!
What the?
You slipped, Ryu! Oh. You slipped!
Ryu slipped!
Oh, man!
He's never gonna live that one down.
Man, he's been the real Razzie this year. He's been the Razzie of OBD Wrestling this year. You cannot deny him. I'm sorry to say this, Ryu, but you gotta do better, man. You gotta do better for your team.
Superman wasn't even tagged in that match.
Nope. Maybe they thought this plan out, man. You know how these two are. They love to one-up each other. Maybe Batman was like, hey, I can do this. You stand back.
Where are they going to go next? I think I know where they're aiming at.
Uh-oh. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Stay tuned. Whoa.
Yeah. Moments ago. Man, the Empire doesn't stop.
Shredder looking for a deal with M. Bison? What the? Reptile again? Ooh!
Ooh! Surprise! Right in your eyes, Reptile!
And now they're out here!
We are live, ladies and gentlemen!
I think I know what's happening here. Shredder saw that Bison. Shredder saw that Reptile was scouting him out, so he hired Bison.
Uh-oh, would this be considered a bounty match? I think so.
I think he wants Bison to keep Reptile out of his hair.
And if I were Bison, this would be the time to collect, because after everything you've went through ever since you joined the Empire, you have been short on the stick, young man.
Did he really join the Empire, or is he just an opportunist looking for some money?
Maybe. Oh. Hold on a second, Never. I gotta use the little man's room. I will be right back.
Oh, there's that slide. Reptile, you better not pose too long. Oh, Bison's still sharp. He scouted that one well. But here's a Reptile fighting back. And he scouts that one too. Shredder might accomplish his goal, I guess, of taking out Reptile here. But Reptile is in the driver's seat again. And now he takes Bison down.
Oh, I got back just in time. I see these two are still at it, Never.
And there's the spear, finally. And I think I know what he has in mind here.
Uh-oh. This dude's not playing around.
But Bison is up and aware.
Yeah, very aware.
Uh-oh, Bison's in trouble now.
Uh-oh.
What's Reptile gonna do here? Nothing good.
Wow. Oh! Oh!
Reptile says you're not taking me out.
You better watch out, Empire. Rebellion is the only thing you gotta worry about.
Well, speaking of the Empire, we got our tag team champions taking on the former tag team champions.
Wow, man. It's been one hell of a night. One hell of a season.
Here comes the former women's tag team champions who you know would love to have another shot at gold.
Yes, the first OBD women's tag team champions who we have not seen. We have not seen them in a while, actually.
Since Outworld?
It's been a minute.
I guess it's the Rumble. Yeah. Hey, we're both in the Rumble.
Man, maybe we are getting a little lazy there. We're wanting to get back to our little old notes. You know what I mean?
In fact, if I recall, it was Daenerys that eliminated Cersei. Or was it the other way around? But one of them did eliminate the other.
Now, yes, hold on. Yeah, you're right. Wow, man. It's crazy how the Royal Rumble can just change things, even for a tag team.
Well, the Rumble's definitely changed the landscape here in the OBD. With the Gina Cyber and Jedah.
The two number one contenders for both the OBD men's and the women's tag championships.
But here come our tag team champions who won their titles in Outworld.
Rightfully so. I mean, you gotta give it up to them. They've been on a roll ever since Beach Brawl. And when I say a roll, I mean Poison Ivy. She may have lost to Teresa at the Death Star Cruise, but after that, she came into power by winning the tag team championships with Harley Quinn.
They really did dominate that battle royal in Outworld. Both of them were standing at the end.
You gotta give it up. They've been through a lot. Sometimes you gotta go through some things in order to get to where you really feel you do that you belong.
They are on top of the tag team division now, and they actually overtook Fire and Fang as the number one team in the OBD.
You gotta give it up to them.
So it's Harley and Cersei to start off. Harley's been surprising in toughness as well. I remember we first saw her back in February, and she lost to Sailor Moon, and we didn't see much of her until Poison Ivy showed up, and ever since she did, Harley Quinn's been on a bit of a roll herself. You must recall that it was Harley Quinn who eliminated both Elsa and Anna in Outworld to take their title and become tag team champions.
Yes, and they have been through lot ever since the show started off, man.
Cersei has the advantage now and tags Daenerys in.
Uh-oh. You gotta give it up to Daenerys. You better watch out for her clothesline. She is deadly.
You know Cersei and Daenerys with... What the hell was that? What in the hell was that? Harley's paying for it right now. Harley now. Uh-oh, we've seen this many... we haven't seen this a lot. Ooh.
Damn.
Catapult straight into the ropes. Here comes the cavalry.
Leader has arrived.
You know Cersei and Daenerys would love another shot at the titles here.
You know it.
Knock off the champions here. They should get it at Ragnarok.
And with a name like Fire and Fang, I know they could use a taste of blood right now after everything they've been through. I mean, they won a battle royal. I think it was at the Death Star Cruise.
Yes, you're right.
Yeah, it was the Death Star Cruise. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I'm tipsy since Thanksgiving.
Now they're double teaming against Poison Ivy. That's smart.
We had a deep fried turkey and it was so succulent. The juice was running off the turkey. I feel like Tariqa right now just talking about it. That's what's so crazy, man.
That's why you were sleepy last night.
Yes, very sleepy. Oh!
Cersei and Daenerys doing a really good job against the champs here, but Poison Ivy. Trying to turn it around.
You gotta give it up to Ivy, though. She does have the power of nature. And a literal kiss of death.
There's another tag. Ooh.
Ooh.
Something's awakened in the tag team, in the former tag team champions that I don't think we've seen since Beach Brawl.
You gotta watch out for Cersei, man. She's a mean bitch and very cold. I mean, man, she fucked over her own brother in more ways than one.
There's that purple bomb. Well, Ivy's still in this thing. It's gonna take more than that. This is a woman that almost knocked off Teresa.
Being the brand new tag team champions, I know they don't want to lose them.
This is a non-title match, but you have to think. If Cersei and Daenerys win here, they will get a title shot at Ragnarok.
All right. That's bragging rights right there, brother.
Ivy now on the apron. There's another tag to Daenerys. Drop kick. You can see Daenerys is getting ready to deliver that big clothesline. I'm surprised. Ivy has not had a good night so far tonight.
Yeah, you know, she's had most of the time in the ring compared to her counterpart, Harley Quinn.
She might want to tag in Harley about right now. Although she's not going to do it there.
Even she is not invincible.
Well, Teresa proved that. So did Sindel. Oh, there's Daenerys off the post. We are up to a 7 count now.
Oh!
Was that a Teresa imitation?
Man, the dark side and his tricks never seem to amaze me, man. I take
up to a 9 count.
Never seem to not amaze me.
The wow. Empire and its tricks, man, like you just said.
Wow. Did you see how far she went with that kick?
She couldn't get back in the ring.
Man, she is out cold.
I guess imitation is the best form of flattery. At any rate, the current champion's victorious here. Or a sting.
Uh-oh. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
An Empire Ventress? Is this an Empire meeting or something? Empire emergency meeting? Well, it's an emergency of a different sort.
Uh-oh.
What the hell is this?
Oh my god. I think the Empire is starting to crack, man.
Is this a part of Ventress' plan?
Oh my god.
Ventress on the ropes now. Not that I mind the Empire fighting the Empire, but what is going on here?
Yeah, I think the ranks are turning in the Empire right now. That's what I'm seeing. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through Bastion, I gain strength!
What is Ventress? Ah, you held on to her for too long, Ventress.
Wow, these guys are... I'll take that back. These gals are really going at it.
I mean, I don't mind. Again, the Empire killing the Empire is a good thing as far as I'm concerned. But what could be their motivations here?
Oh, shit.
You sure this was a good idea?
Oh!
What?
Oh!
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Run, Hot. Get the hell out of there.
Oh, damn. Oh, my God.
Oh!
Wow.
What's... Oh! Anna, you just came at the wrong time.
Wrong place. Oh!
Luke and Vader's still going at it!
Ooh! Whoa! Oh my God! This is Odyssey 1 all over again, man!
It is definitely Ragnarok season.
This place is going off and the roof is on fire.
There's Luke. Daring Vader to come into the ring.
Wow. Yeah, he's not finished.
Gauntlet thrown.
Father versus Son Part 2?
What now?
Uh-oh.
And those four women are still fighting. Anna has been put in an ambulance. What is going on tonight?
It's been pure chaos on a highway to hell.
Speaking of hell. Speaking of hell. What could Sidious want?
Man, this man is up to no good ever since he came to the OBD, and you know it.
His plans have been creating chaos and destruction all year long. 2020 is his year, you can say.
Yes, Palpatine's year.
Whoa. Luke, are you sure about this?
Uh-oh.
Whoa! Jedah! Oh, shit!
Oh, man.
He's back.
Here we go.
Palpatine is... Oh, here he comes! Ah. Palpatine's running away!
Oh, man! What's gonna happen next?
See you next week!